morning, guys. Now, I'm sure you've noticed if you drive on the roads quite a bit, maybe even if you don't, you've seen these convoys of trucks, and Army trucks, Marine trucks. They're the 88 Mike, oblong-looking engine sitting on the back of the truck. Haulers. Not deuce and a halves, but the ones that actually haul like the freight containers and stuff. Now, if you notice, a lot of these trucks are carrying red, blue, green containers, and they're marked with hazmat symbols. Now, I know a lot of people, unless you drive a truck or you just make it a hobby, I guess, you don't know what those symbols mean. But most of them are explosive. At least the convoy I ran into yesterday, every single container was marked with explosive. And they weren't the normal explosive hazmat. It was the high yield, which means that they're carrying something that goes boom in the night, like big boom. Anyway, if you talk to these people, these guys, and they talk to me because I'm a veteran, they seem nervous. They won't tell you what's going on because they can't. They're not supposed to. But they'll say, "Oh, we're doing training." You know, you walk up to them and you get a conversation with one of the lower ranks, like a private, a specialist, something like that. And you usually get them talking. They're not like the sergeants. And you can get them to slip up sometimes. But I try not to do that simply because of, well, what should be obvious reasons. I don't want to get them in trouble, and I don't want to get in trouble. But what they usually tell me is that it's a training op. And anyone who's done stuff like that knows that when their automatic response is a training op, it's not a training op. You don't haul live explosives in a training op, and that's the only reason those containers would be labeled with that hazmat logo that it was. It's not a training op; they're hauling shit. Now, the other thing is this is up in Ohio, and Fort Boston Woods isn't in Ohio, and that's where they train the 88 Mike. So there's no reason to have a training op up in this area, especially when I followed them for about, I don't know, 200 or so miles. I didn't follow them. They were going along my route. I just decided not to pass them. They don't do training ops that are that long. Your training op is generally you drive around for a couple hours. You know, and it's usually you stay in the same location. You don't haul explosives on an interstate in a convoy that stretches a mile and a half long when you're not hauling shit 200 miles down the interstate heading across the U.S. Now, these guys were headed westbound, I want to say. Yeah, westbound's what it was. So they're going somewhere, they're hauling this shit, and they're taking it somewhere. I don't know where it's going, because they moved a lot of the stuff around in the bases. If it was 10 years ago, I could probably tell you where it was going. But now they've moved everything, and I got no clue. Maybe somebody that's keeps up with this stuff better than I do would know. But yeah, so I'm sure you all have seen a lot of this around, and it, with everything else going on, it makes you wonder, because in the last, I'd say, 6 months, I've seen more and more and more of these convoys. Like, I swear I pass these things every single day, and I drive all over the U.S., and I see them pretty much every day, mile-long convoys hauling shit, whether it be Humvees, whether it be Bradleys, whether it be tanks. You know, I even saw one convoy of Strikers just driving along the road. And then, like I said, yesterday was the convoy of high-yield explosives. So I'm not sure what they're preparing for, what's going on, but they're not hauling it to the coast to be shipped off. They're hauling it inland, which should say enough. So they're either hauling it to store it somewhere, or they're hauling it in preparation for something, and most likely it's preparation for something. But what they need all that equipment for in the center of the U.S., I have no idea. And pretty much everyone I've seen has been traveling toward central USA. I don't know what they're building out there, or where they're going specifically, but I know which direction they're heading. So, and all of them, like even the ones down south, they're heading north and west. And when they're up north near Chicago, they're heading south and west. up for something in some central location because they're all headed in the same direction. And it's a pattern, basically, that you see. What it's for, I got no idea. And I'm not going to speculate. It's the Army. I mean, they can be fucking hauling the shit to dump sites for all I know. But it just, I don't think that's what it is because I've never seen them do this before. And when I was in the Army, we had local dump sites that we took it to or we disposed of it ourselves. So it's not like, I can't find a valid reason other than preparation than to be hauling shit from every location in the U.S. to a central point. I don't know where that central point is. Somebody else might. Leave it in the comments if you do. If you got videos, great. That's cool to provide links for people that way they can see what's going on. But yeah, so just speculative, you know, what do you think's going on? That stuff, hash some ideas about, because information's where it's at. You know, if you've got information, you can be aware of your surroundings, and if you're aware of your surroundings, you can be better prepared for whatever is going on. I mean, maybe they're going to bomb North Korea. I don't know. Maybe they're going to do something else. Like I said, I'm not really going to speculate anything because you two have as a habit of they've been starting to kick us off the channels and delete our videos and shit. So I'm not gonna do any of that in this video or probably any other for obvious reasons because I would like to be able to get information out without being banned. You know what I mean? I think there's a march against Google going on for censorship somewhere. I don't remember where it was, but I think they're holding one soon. They're like, it's a protest against Google censorship. Honestly, I have a problem with any censorship at all, considering the First Amendment. I don't think it's right on any level. Now, like that guy that got fired from Google, for example. You know, he works for Google, and Google's a company that has policies you have to follow like any company. I watched the video of what he said, and I don't think that was valid reasons to fire him, and I hope he sues, because that's bullshit. I mean, he wrote a memo that was very polite and straightforward about multiple genders, and he basically stated that, in his opinion, it would be confusing to have 50 genders. That's not specific of what he said, but that was the gist of it. He just said that, you know, Google should stick with the biological two genders rather than, you know, and then maybe put an option in for LGBT or something like that, because that pretty much covers everything. So they can check LGBT rather than male or female if they're uncomfortable putting male or female. But that was basically the gist of what he suggested, and they fired him for it. Now, to me, that seems to be a pretty, you know, way to go. I mean, it takes care of the problem, and it shouldn't offend anybody. So I don't understand what the issue with that was. And I think it was just basically a message more than anything else. And, you know, this guy may have had private opinions or whatever, but, you know, like I said, I don't know, I'm not Google. But, yeah. Just wanted to make you all be on the lookout for those convoys because they're everywhere now. Like, you can see them everywhere. And be aware of what's going on. Now, I know that us militia guys and other things like that, we've got pretty much everything as far as, like, what we're doing and what's going on covered. But it's, we're not that large. Like, there's a lot of us, and there's a lot of people that would join us if it came down to that. But everyone needs to be prepared, whether you're willing to take up arms, whether you're or not, or whether you're just willing to do whatever. I'm not encouraging anybody to break the law or do anything, so don't take it that way. I'm saying that your First Amendment is there, and your Second Amendment is there to protect the First Amendment. The Second Amendment was never intended for self-defense against robbery or anything like that. It was put in place. place to defend yourself against tyranny. And that's what the Constitution is about. It's your freedoms and your right to defend yourself against tyranny. Now, do we live in a tyrannical government? I'm not one of these conspiracy theorists that's going to tell you yes. I can see a lot of the shit going on, and I think many things need to change. I think there's a lot of problems in politics, especially with the way the money is run. The Fed Reserve is an illegal bank. It's not an illegal bank per se, but it engages in illegal activity with the United States. Like your taxes, for example. You cannot be taxed on a currency that does not belong to the United States and is not backed by gold or silver or whatever. It's paper. It's illegal currency. The U.S. currency, the dollars you have now, are not legal currency. Like, technically, you shouldn't even be able to buy anything with them because they have no value. So it's a fake system, which involves counterfeit money.
1 1/4 miles.
Now, the way the Fed Reserve works is it's a private bank that sells currency to the United States government. The United States government buys currency from the Fed Reserve. So it's a private bank that sells currency at interest to the U.S. So, you know, is that fucked up? Yeah. But is that just the way it is? Yeah. I mean, there's not really you can do about it. You got to pay your taxes and press charges on it. Whether it's legal or not isn't really a concern because the nation is so entrenched in this, in the system now. And that's the way they want it. Now, that's not a conspiracy theory.
Either of them.
You can look that up in tax law. You can look that up in whatever. I think some guy actually won a Supreme Court case against the Fed Reserve, as far as that's concerned. And I forget which one it was, but I remember reading about it. And he doesn't have to pay taxes anymore. Now, if you try and do that yourself, they're going to prosecute you. And you'll have to take it to the Supreme Court. That doesn't mean that you don't have to pay your taxes. You're going to have to pay your taxes. Now, the other reason that they're switching to mostly digital currency now, if you notice, there's not a lot of cash anymore. It's mostly digital because they can tax digital currency because it's created by them. It's not created by the Fed Reserve. But we have a system now where the digital currency is backed up by counterfeit fake currency. Should, you'd think, make that illegal too, but it's not illegal since it's mathematically based in ones and zeros and whatnot, and there's a whole thing to that too. But, yeah, so, and then I went rambling, I'm sorry, you know me, I do that. I don't personally think the government is tyrannical itself. I think that there are many problems with many people in the government, and I think those people are corrupt. I think the system would work if you didn't have assholes running things. And I'm not really talking about Trump, because from what I've noticed, he's actually trying to fix shit, but he's being blocked at every angle, so he like I said before, he's like a prisoner in his own office. I mean, he can't really do anything except executive orders, because nobody will pass his shit. They're blocking everything. And I guess that's the globalist or whatever the hell Alex Jones calls it. I mean, it makes sense. Establishment, whatever. But I think that there's just a lot going on and a lot of different moving parts. And I think some of those parts need to be replaced. I think that people have too much power in office. The government has too much power. That's definitely, they've been overreaching for years. Everybody knows that. I think that they need to be severely restricted in what they can and can't do. I don't think that they should be able, I don't think that Congress should be able to decide what becomes a law and what doesn't. Now, I realize that that's how the system is designed, but I don't think the forefathers understood the degree to which corruption would set place. They figured after such a traumatic event that happened that changed everyone's perspective on everything, that that would last. And they, even though they had the foresight to plan for if it didn't last, they didn't have the foresight, or I guess the psychological intelligence, to plan for psychological warfare, which is what goes on with the nation now. You got your media, which hypes everybody up and causes false riots so that they can declare whatever. They can have excuses to up-armor the police, to declare military law if need be, and all of this other stuff. And that fits right into their agenda, because if they declare martial law, then the Constitution is null and void at that point in time, and they can declare that everyone has to surrender their arms and go to your house and kill you if you don't. If you refuse, they'll say that you're a threat and they'll kill you. And that's military. That's a police state. That's military law. And you see today, and no offense to the good officers out there, but you see a lot of officers today and they abuse their power. And I know that some of the good officers on the ground don't see it as much, but I think that's because they're bias blind. And it's not that they intentionally overlook stuff, it's that they watch some of the stuff going on and they hear about some of the stuff going on and they just kind of, and they don't realize that it is very prevalent. I mean, I see new news articles every single day of, you know, this cop did this or that cop did that. And I realize the media is pretty biased, but when I watch the video and I go, oh, that's fucked up. You know, it's, if you're scared, you don't need to be an officer. If you can't disarm somebody with a knife without shooting them, you don't need to be an officer. Now, if the guy's a Navy SEAL or trained or whatever, and you know for a fact they know how to use that knife and that gun ain't gonna do, and you're in you in close range, you ain't gonna be able to disarm them. Well, that's another thing altogether. You know, yeah, okay, use your firearm. But if you don't know that, and it's some drunk guy with a knife, you don't have a right to shoot him. You go over there, you disarm him, you put him in handcuffs. It's that simple. And then there's just too much violence going on. And like I've said before, with gun violence, it's not really, I don't think you should disarm the police because they need their weapons. But I think that, like Germany and like a lot of European countries, you should enforce exceedingly strict laws, which if a police fires his, like in Germany, if you fire your weapon as a police officer, you're on 3 months suspension without pay until they figure out what the hell went on and whether what you actually did was legal. Like, that's, it's some hardcore shit. You know, you can't cowboy shit. If you fire your weapon, you're fucked in Germany, unless you have a damn good reason. And if they find out that you even violated one little policy, one tiny policy, you didn't announce yourself.
Construction was reported on I-70.
You know, you illegally pulled somebody over. You're going to prison. You're no longer going to be an officer. You're going to prison. That's what it is, and it's pretty much you're going to prison for every offense. And I think it's like something 3 to 5 years in prison and a hefty fine or something. It's ridiculously hardcore. And, you know, the cops in Germany, they're assholes, but they're professional assholes. You know, they do abuse their power and they do intimidate, but they don't, they won't beat you, and they won't kill you, and they will never fire their weapon at you unless they have damn good reason. They'll point it at you, but they're not going to fire it at you. You know, you can come at them with a knife and they're not even going to raise their weapon at you. They'll fucking disarm you and put you in handcuffs, and maybe that's, and that's what needs to happen here. Police need to be held accountable for every single thing they do. And some are. Some departments are really good about that. Some are. Some towns are fucking awesome. And I got no problem with officers in general. But it's the assholes that are giving you all a bad name. And if you can't police yourselves, then there need to be laws which do it for you. You know, you should not be allowed to fire your weapon without a damn good reason. You being scared is not a reason to fire your weapon. I'm sorry, it's not. Your life is... And, you know, important than a criminal's. Your life is no more important than a regular person's, or a veteran of the U.S. Army, or military, or Navy, or whatever, Marines. Your life is no more important than anyone else's. If you think for a second when you walk up to somebody's car and draw your gun out, they're not scared shitless of you, you're wrong. So, if you have the right to kill them because you're scared, do they not have the same right? Because if they don't, then that means that you're above the law. And that's fucked up, and that's wrong. Because if you pull your gun on me for no reason whatsoever, I know you're going to use it, because that's the way you all are. When you pull your gun out and you point it at me, that is an immediate threat on my life. If I have not broken the law, I'm going to defend myself. And that's the way pretty much everybody else is either. And I'm trained, so I don't need a firearm to defend myself. If you're within 10 feet of me, it's not going to end up well for you. I don't care. You all don't get the training you need combat-wise. I realize that. But, you know, you don't pull your weapon out on somebody for no reason. It's just, it's not good. Yeah, I would probably go to jail and whatnot. But, you know, if you pull your gun out with the intention of killing me, I should be allowed to defend myself. And anybody should defend themselves. And I'm not saying police are bad or attack the cops or anything like that. What I'm trying to say is that if the police have a right to shoot you and kill you because they're scared, then you should have the same right. If you are scared, genuinely scared, then you should have the right to kill them. I mean, because neither one of you is worth any more than anyone else. Your life is just as valuable as mine. My life is just as valuable as yours. That badge does not elevate you to some elite thing in society. It doesn't. This hat doesn't elevate me to some elite thing in society. Yeah, sure, you deserve respect. Because you get shot at every day and you put your life on the line, just like I did, just like other people do. You deserve respect. But people are stupid. They're not just going to respect you. And just because they don't respect you doesn't give you the right to pull your gun out and shoot them. Because you think they're a threat. That's not how that works. It's not how it works. The U.S. is the only country it works like that in. That's civilized countries anyway. You know, in Iraq, there's no civilized. It's whatever, you know. It's Wild West. And I can understand that kind of mentality there. Now, if you're in Iraq, I can understand shoot first, ask questions later. Oh, fuck yeah. Hey, that's just the way it is. Or Afghanistan, or you know, any of those countries where it's just complete and utter chaos and anarchy. But here in America, we are a civilized people with civilized laws and law-abiding